And so if you have any inadequacies in your entry, that's going to show up at the very end exponentially. So I like to tell my high schoolers that I coach that, you know, if you don't get your entry right, it's going to show up at the end. So we call it, that's what I call the mirror effect. So everything you do at the beginning is what's going to happen at the end. So we have to know that and get it fixed ahead of time to give yourself a better chance to succeed at the end. Okay. So with that being said, there's a few tenets that you got to get right in order to throw well, right? And so again, that happens at the very beginning. I've had this conversation with Mo about a million times, and it's not really a conversation, it's more of a lecture, a really aggressive lecture. He's a great guy, and he just wants to see you do great things. And so he's a really big entry is most important. And so a few tenets that are very important to this, okay, is A, establishing a good base. So whatever your good base is typically a solid quarter squat. So I know everybody's done a box squat before. At a solid quarter squat position, you can load a lot of weight and still feel really strong off of a box. So my good quarter squat is right here, right? And that's typically where I start. So wherever that is, you can fill that out right now. Next up in this process, okay, slightly over the left side, right? So remember we talked earlier, Mo was talking about left side axis. So some coaches will talk about trying to wind on the big right side and shift left. I think that's too many variables at one point in time. So if you just establish yourself on that left early, the better. So think of the weight distribution as like 60-40, okay? Is that pretty simple for everyone? So all right, so everybody getting your good quarter squat. Get slightly on that left. Now you should feel that thing, it's really in the ground, right? Really stable. That's what you want throughout your wind, okay? And really throughout your throw, it's gonna carry through. Okay, so as you're on that left side, now I want you to take your torso, keep everything in a straight line. Big chest, right? That doesn't mean sit back, so don't do this. Keep everything neutral. Big chest here, right? Just think about like setting up for a clean. Slightly on that left side. Now I want you to take everything, straight line, turn your torso, about 45 degrees. Is everybody right-handed, by the way? Okay, perfect. Yeah, so slide on your left. Turn right about 45 degrees. That's exactly where you want to be on your entry, okay? And again, this helps establish that left side axis. And this is ultimately going to give you a lot of time to push the ball out and around. And a big key for this, too, when you turn here, you can set the low point. So we can all do this with our arms, so everybody spread out a little bit. All right, so get in your stable position. Good quarter squat, slightly over that left. Turn the right about 45 degrees. Okay, so now what I'm gonna say next, you gotta see the ball back. And what that means is as you come up for your wind, right? So our hands are here. Your hands gotta be active from here on out. And what I mean by that, I'm gonna say something along the lines of catch the hands, right? So that means push them out, right? Nice, long, and loose. Push them out. And what that does is it's gonna establish what we call the low point. And I'm sure everybody's, this is your first time throwing. But the low point is exactly, obviously, what it's called, the lowest point of the orbit, right? So there's a low point, and there's a high point, the opposite of that. So you wanna put that low point right on the inside of that right foot, almost right toe. I'll explain why that's super important here in a minute. But all I want you to do right now, again, set up that good entry position, long, loose arms, right? And I want you to see the ball back. I want you, so we don't have a hammer on hands right now. I want you to see both hands work all the way around. Around, out and up. Out and up, that's what I like to say, out and up. Really feel those shoulders nice, long, and loose. Turn that torso a little bit to the blue. There you go. Good. Lock the shoulders. Everything's afloat. Maybe a little bit. Yes. There you go. You gotta be in a good, stable position. Remember, stability is key. You live at home, right here. Right here is where you live. you get anywhere out of that, the hammer will bully you because it picks up speed. When it picks up speed, it picks up force, and it picks up mass. It's real heavy. All right, so we got that established. Does anybody have any questions in regards to how I want this thing to look?
So you're saying for you, you're just staying on the left side the whole time, so your foot's flat. You don't really do this.
I don't twist it at all. I stay here again. It establishes that left side axis early, right? And that's what Coach Mo spoke about earlier. And that's going to send you pretty much down a straight path in the circle if you do it right, right? As long as you don't mess with the orbit, you'll be fine. And that's the whole point. So, again, the main idea is establish a left side axis. So I want everybody to say, what are we establishing? A
left side axis.
Say it again.
Left side axis.
All right, one more time.
Left side axis.
Perfect. All right. All right, so let's get a hammer in our hand. Let's do it. So everybody can clear it out so I can see you all this way. Learning how to push the ball, right? Get that right side moving, that's it. Sway the hips. A lot of people want to sway the hips at the beginning. Keep everything stacked, everything stable, okay? Yeah. So even though some of us have probably seen Ivan Tikhon, who's arguably one of the best hammer throwers ever, you got to be a special type of person to do something like that. Yeah. So my feet are at the front of the circle. I don't actually step in at all. I step up in the back. So everything's just straight down. Yeah. Try to keep it as natural as possible. So whatever you do, but stay stable. Right? Remember, stability is key. There you go. Good. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Hey, good. There you go, Jamar. Jamar, turn that torso a little bit more to the right. A little more to the field, you'll be good. That's going to be textbook. Yeah, this is the whole point. You got to have mobility.
Nice mobility. Frankie, turn a little bit more to the field, my man. Good, there you go. All right, stay on that left side. Don't start swaying over to that right. Everybody's tendency is want to swing over to the right. Remember, stay on that left. Lock it in. It's your anchor. All right, when everybody feels good with that, we're going to go to the next one.
Do you, Alex?
Yeah.
Going back to the, so I usually try to turn and reach back to get more tension. Do you consider that a mistake, or is that naturally what you feel?
You want
to
do that, but it's hard. You got to be disciplined enough. If you're going to reach back, you can't reach, right? You got to allow that reflex to take over, right?
Okay.
So you still got to be stable. And this is a hard thing to do. All right, so now after right hand, we're going to take the hammer, put it in our left hand. And all I want y'all to do, same thing, set up normal, and I'm going to let y'all see my back a little bit. Whatever you think is most important that they need to work on right then and there. Yeah. That's a good question. All right, so next, right, we're gonna do what they call reverse grip. So typically our normal grip is the left hand's grabbing the handle, right? Right hand over the top. But this time we're actually gonna do it the opposite way. So we're gonna, so you might need to switch your glove, go ahead and do that now, put it on your right hand. But I typically, I got one of these bad boys. So I can just slide my fingers right in. Right, so now we're gonna take the right hand, hold the handle, left hand over the top, okay? And so when we do this, okay, these are just regular winds at this point. So remember, set up that good position, create that left side what?
Axial.
I wasn't good enough. Say it again.
Axial.
Left side what?
Axial.
All right, perfect. So establish that left side axis, light torso turn. All I want is up and out, up and out. Keep in mind, try to keep that low point right inside that right foot. Good swing. So what you should, what I should see from everyone for a good entry, I tell the kids I coach, right? You know a good entry, if it looks like a swing, so a good swing is here, right? Rather than a chop. A chop is this, right? But a good swing. Swing, chop. You don't want to see a chop, okay? So it should be a shallow U rather than a sharp V shape. That makes sense for everyone? All right, let's get it going. But make sure that right side is moving that hammer. Cast those hands out as it comes over the top of the head. Cast those arms. You'll be winding forever. Yeah, so I hope. Yeah, he would have kept going. That was crazy. Yeah.
Tell me when to stop, coach. I got you.
So, when you focus more 45, you have a low point over the right leg. When you're thinking about coming out in the entry, are you thinking out on the right side? Are you thinking out in front of you?
Yeah, okay. So, he asked a very good question. Okay, so he asked, so if I'm on this left side and I'm thinking about
opening it up, right? Make sure I'm getting that right so far. Am I thinking about staying long here or staying long here or somewhere over here? The answer to that, you're making it really complicated. You always want to stay long throughout, right? So the whole thing. All right, Frank, I'm going to get this.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
Yeah, don't worry. So the good thing. Made it really complicated. The essence of this is you want to keep everything really long, okay? So as you go to wine, when I say stay long on the right, you're also going to want to stay long on the left, right? Long all the way through. Create your horizon, right?
So you're thinking about out the whole time?
The entire time. You got to play the strength of the event, right?
Right.
You got to keep it long. That's how you build up speed, and that's what leads the distance. Yeah.
Thanks.
You know that, Mr. Engineer?
I do.
Yeah, go ahead. So when you do step in? Okay, perfect. Yeah, okay, that's a good question. So how it translates is it gives you more time, right? So if the radius is a lot longer, you can be a lot more efficient. You're not using as much energy. So it stays long, right? So as everybody likes to talk about countering, I don't necessarily like to say countering because everything's more of a reaction. So if you're stable, the ball's working around you, boom, and then you just follow the path, right? That makes sense? No worries.
When do you start that after the second wine? Do you wait till right over your head or are you trying to get, when do you start your entry?
Yeah, it's pretty much right as soon as I get over the head. So. Me and my coach talk about active hands, right? So the activity of the hands begins here. And everybody's been doing a pretty good job of that, that's why I haven't really said it. And that's why I like to say cast. So I say, you know, out and up, and casting out. Because when you cast out, your hands become active, right? But yeah, the active hands are here. Boom, right? If your hands are active here, it's too late. Low point shifts, you lose the ball.
Coming straight out. Second one.
But not that hard of a move. It's just boom. I stay here, work around myself. I don't do this, right? I don't pull away from it.
Right.
Shorten the radius. Keep everything long. That makes sense?
Yeah, it makes sense. Thanks.
How do you learn patience to get that ball left?
A lot of time. A lot of time discipline really is you gotta feel it first, I think, and really try to challenge it. What is long before you lose posture? What is long before you physically aren't strong enough yet to maintain that position? And then just work through it. Is that the answer you wanted?
Yeah, well, it's good. I know I have a problem before.
Yeah.
So I'm like, I'm trying to do extra things. I'm trying like the left hand drill, right hand drill, just lift up all the arms. But I always find myself pulling off of it before it gets stuck.
Yeah, so that's all. That's just discipline. You got to learn how to stay really long and let the ball work around you, right? So that's kind of what the left hand's for, is to teach you how to eliminate the resistance. Freeing up that left side. So eventually, boom, free, you just let it go, right? Right side, boom, boom, right?
Talk about pushing with the right side. So when you push on the entry, it's really from the lat, right? It's really from the lat, it's really from the hip. Boom, push. Because if you push from the traps, you can't. The ball doesn't move as fast, you can see that. So
Relaxed muscle is a fast muscle, right? A tense muscle is a slow muscle, right? Does that make sense? Relaxed muscle is a fast muscle. Yeah, so this one with the right hand specifically, it just allows you better connection with the hammer. So you feel that push. Because next we're gonna go to this regular grip, right? Up speed and momentum, what ends up happening is we like to try to fight back on it. So like as it starts picking up, everybody's done it, you'll feel the ball at some point try to pull you forward and you try to yank back. You got to fight your typical nature, right? It's kind of crazy, but if you stay in the middle, an isometric hold is the strongest contraction that you can have. So if you're literally sitting in the middle like this, like I talk about being stable, you don't have to worry about trying to fight the hammer. You let the ball work around you. All right, so everybody, before we go to the next one, feel free to get some water and just relax for a second, and then we're gonna take a moment.